Chivalry 2 uses a class system, and in this video I wanna showcase what different classes and subclasses this game has to offer. This should serve as an overview for people who either don't have access to the beta, or those who have played the beta but didn't have time to unlock all the subclasses. There are 3 melee classes and 1 range class in the game. Each of these 4 classes divides into 3 subclasses, which makes a total of 12 subclasses. I'm trying to avoid making too many comments on which class or weapon is better or worse, just because it's very likely that weapon stats and damage numbers will get adjusted before the game releases. If you're new to this channel and don't want to miss out on any future content, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Let's start with the Knight. The Knight has the most health out of all the classes in the game. It is, however, also the slowest class, and has on top of that a 50% increased cooldown on the dodge ability. During full sprint, knights can perform a tackle attack that knocks opponents to the ground. The knight's special abilities get charged up by blocking attacks and taking damage. The first knight subclass is the officer, a seasoned veteran with equipment that combines speed and power. He has access to fast two-handed weapons that deal good damage. His special ability is the trumpet, that upon use grants nearby allies health regen for a short period of time. The officer has access to throwing knives that he can equip together with his secondary one-handed weapon. The second knight class is the guardian. The guardian is a wall of iron and steel that excels at holding the line. The guardian fights with a big shield and a one-handed weapon. Shields can block archer projectiles and lose less stamina on block. They can break, however. The guardian's special ability is the banner. Banners can be planted and heal allies over time. The third knight subclass is the crusader, a true bruiser that combines crushing power with great armor. He has access to high damage two-handed weapons. The crusader has 2 throwing axes in his arsenal that deal pretty good damage when thrown. His special ability is the oil pot, a clay pot that shatters on impact and ignites a small area. Moving on from the knight, we have the footman. The footman has a bit less health than the knight, but can move a bit faster. Footmen are medics, meaning that they all have bandage kits as their special ability. The ability gets charged up by healing and reviving teammates. All footmen also have a sprint charge attack that deals massive damage. The first subclass in this group is the poleman, a melee support that keeps opponents at a distance with impressively long shafts. The poleman has access to the longest weapons in the game, like the halberd and the spear. He is the only non-knight unit that can perform a tackle. The poleman also has a stronger charge attack than the other footman subclasses. Additionally, he can build a spike trap, which can help with certain objectives. Next, we have the man-at-arms. The man-at-arms uses a one-handed weapon and a shield. He has increased movement speed while holding a one-handed weapon, and he also has reduced cooldown on the dodge ability, which makes him very agile and evasive. The third footman class is the field engineer. Field engineers can deploy barricades, which can help with controlling certain objectives. They can also choose between a spike trap and a bear trap. Engineers deal 100% extra damage to breakables and can heal themselves by reviving allies. Their weapon arsenal doesn't excel in melee combat, however. Moving forward, we have the Vanguard class. Out of the 3 melee classes, Vanguards have the smallest health pool but the highest movement speed. They also have more stamina than footmen and knights. During full sprint, Vanguards can perform a leaping strike that deals tremendous damage. Getting a kill with a leaping strike charges up the Vanguard's special ability. Vanguards are, due to their low health pool, a vulnerable target for archers. The Brute is the first Vanguard subclass, and he is the glass cannon character in Chivalry 2. He has access to the largest, high damage weapons in the game, like the Greatsword and the Maul. The Brute doesn't have a significant sidearm. He has access to 2 mallets that can be thrown for decent damage. Like the Crusader, the Brute's special ability is also Oil Pot. The second Vanguard subclass is the Raider. The Raider is the only class in the game that can have two strong two-handed weapons in his loadout. This allows him to specialize against multiple classes by equipping weapons that have different damage types, like for example a blunt type hammer and a cut type messer. The Raider's special ability is the Trumpet. The third Vanguard subclass is the Ambusher, a battlefield murderer that ambushes unaware foes with powerful specials. The Ambusher is Chivalry 2's Assassin class that deals additional damage with backstabs. He can only equip one-handed weapons that deal pretty low damage without the backstabs. The Ambusher has access to throwing knives. His special ability is Quiver, which fully restores his throwing knife ammo. Let's have a look at the Archer class. Archers have the least amount of health and stamina out of all classes. Their movement speed is on par with footmen. There is a maximum amount of archers one team can have. The first subclass of the Archer family is the Longbowman. The Longbowman, well, uses a bow. Bows have good reload speed, but holding it drawn drains stamina and reduces accuracy. The Longbowman's special ability is the Brazier, a placeable fire source for igniting arrows and bolts. This ability gets charged up via landing headshots. Bowmen also have access to a spike trap. The second Archer subclass is the Crossbowman. Crossbows deal high damage and are due to its blunt type damage extra effective against knights and footmen. The biggest drawback is the long reload speed that requires the Crossbowman to stand still. The Crossbowman has access to a Pavis shield that can be deployed and used as a cover. His special ability that gets charged up via landing headshots is the Banner. The last Archer subclass is the Skirmisher, a hybrid melee ranged fighter. As his main weapon, he can choose between javelins or throwing axes, which can both be thrown or used as a melee weapon. Additionally, the Skirmisher has a small shield that does good jab damage. He is also equipped with a bear trap. The Skirmisher's special ability is Quiver. It restocks all ammo upon use. The ability is charged up via landing melee or ranged headshots. During full sprint, the Skirmisher can perform a leaping strike. Obviously, this subclass is stat-wise inferior to other melee classes. Alright guys, that's it for this video. I hope I could give you a good overview of all the classes and subclasses and how they work in Chivalry 2. Let me know in the comments section what your favorite class is. If you enjoyed this video, then please leave a thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel for more content. As always, thank you all for watching and see you soon.